steps up, looking long, now shoots it to the near side. It is caught. Lorenzo Neal, the fullback, takes it out across the 30, and it's a first down for Fresno State. 55. Double wideouts to the top of your screen. Now the dog shifting to the eye. Dilfer in quarterback, first down, second man through. It's the tailback, and oh, does he have running room? Rivers out across the 46. A flag is down back at the 33. Jason Sehor, the junior college transfer from Mount Shasta Community College, finally brought him down.
And Phil, that most likely is someone in the neutral zone lining up.
It's against Southern California. They'll decline
the
penalty.
Down on the field.
Both sides, defense, decline. First down.
I used to hate those quick poppers like that when I used to play football. They're the hardest one because the defensive lineman gets in there and really can't shed the block before the back is already through the hole.
Back at the 10-yard line is Curtis Conway, and make no mistake about it, Mahoney's going to put this one out of bounds. They do not want Conway to get it. Wait a minute, he puts it down the middle of the field. Little pooch putt, and oh, did he do it nicely? Dead at the 7-yard line. Sophomore at quarterback. There's the draw. It is Lorenzo Neal, and he's got it. Still on his feet. Spins to the 40-yard line. A gain of 8. Michael Ross to the right. Play action. Dilfer looking for his tight end. Sends it out to the right side. It is caught. Lorenzo Neal carries it to the 24-yard line.
Boy, credit Neal on a great move once he catches the football. He's the safety valve out in the flat. Dilfer looks downfield. There's nothing there. Now just dump it out in the flat and watch the move that Neal puts on. Plant, get back to the inside, then pick up that positive yardage.
It is Creighton again, and he is grabbed at the line by Zach Ricks. The senior from Buckeville, California, grabbed him, and they're duking it out down there. Tell you, tempers began to flare for Fresno State about 2 weeks ago.
Well, watch Zach Ricks in the middle. He's number 95. This is the way you play. Control the double team, split it, get right back up on your feet. Come down and yank him back, pull him back.
From the one. Over the top goes Deion Strother, touchdown, Southern Cal.
Phil, they call this yards after contact. It's how many yards do you get once you're hit. Now, right there, he's hit. Now, watch that leg drive. Just keep those legs churning, and he picks up another 3, almost 4 yards.
In the mud. Third down, draw. Lorenzo Neal has got a first down and a whole bunch more. Whoa, did he run right through a tackle. Hollenquist finally got a good lead block by Ron Rivers. And Rivers only goes 5'9", 190.
Well, this is a 12-yard run, but you're right. Right there, he breaks the tackle. Now, pick up that blocker, get that head down, pick up that extra yardage. That turned a negative play into a positive play.
This center of gravity must be about 18 inches off the turf. Dilfer, look at that time. He can run it. And he's going to do it. Got a good block. He's at the 40, the SC 35, and down there. State's gonna go. And look at those fourth down numbers this year. Dilfer. It is cut. It's a first down at the 23-yard line. Titus Winans, his 34th reception this year.
And what a job by Winans to get his foot down in bound. Watch this. Simple out, drive him off the ball. Now watch the foot down. Catch the football, keep that foot down. Again, watch him concentrate from the end zone on getting that foot down in bounds. Catch the football, and that foot down.
In the slot, Malcolm Seabrock. Play action. Dilfer putting it up. It is caught and out of bounds. Goes Malcolm Seabrock at the SC3.
Thrown
is the T-heavy formation. The give again, straight ahead. Touchdown, Fresno State, Lorenzo Neal.
Power football, big man on big man. Strength. You see everybody leading up there? Just put that head down and power up through there.
A. Simpson. Join the offensive backfield of Southern California. Second and five. Johnson looking. It is knocked down at the 8-yard line. Great coverage by James Burton, the right corner. Wide to the left is Larry Wallace. To the right, Morton and Hanna. Creighton. Whoa, is he nailed? And it's James Burton again.
He was going to do is they were going to try to run Burton deep, and he didn't go with the receiver. He came up on the run support, and there was no one out there to block Burton when he comes up. Bam! That's the way you want a center, a cornerback to come up. Watch him come into your screen right there. Turn it in, put him down for a loss.
Cole Ford, you look at his numbers, 11 of 19 this year. It's long enough, and it is no good. He missed it to the left. At the 35. It's a first down for the Bulldogs.
Well, we keep on seeing Lorenzo Neal make those great cuts. This is a little slide draw. Good block up front there by Rivers. He gets the first block. Then Neal just keeps on churning those legs to pick up the yardage.
Five to play on the third period. Dilfer. He'll lay it up. It is caught by Titus Winans. Whoa, what a job he did keeping his feet in bounds.
Well, that's the mark of a great receiver when he not only catches the football, but concentrates on getting that foot down. He knows he's close to the sideline, and watch this concentration. Catches the football. Now, quickly, get those feet down. You see him drag that right foot? Watch him just drag it to get it down. Make sure he just kind of gets him down.
Tonight, Dilfer has been untouched. There's a draw. Lorenzo Neal. And look at him turn to the 32. James and Russ Hartman, great up front blocking, just pushing the line. It's first lead of the game. This will be from 43 yards away. As long as 44, it's got plenty of distance. Well, he got it. The Bulldogs have taken a lead. Lead is set to kick it away. It is Estrus Creighton and Travis Hanna deep. It'll be Hanna again. A moment ago, he returned 150 yards. Not this time, as he is grabbed around the ankles and spun down. Gabe Romero is the guy who spun Hanna to the ground.
And watch Romero just break through the slice. Just comes right through clean. Nobody touches him. There he is.
By Johnson. I thought he unloaded it. Johnson pulled it down and ran right into the arms of Demetrius Edwards. Seven. Trojans from the shotgun. Johnson flags her down. Johnson. Pocket collapses and Johnson collapses. Surface and Brad Bell finally got to him.
Well, the flag could play a big part on this play. But once Johnson stops looking downfield, he's lost. The quarterback needs to regain his composure and quickly look downfield, get rid of the football, not take a 10, 12-yard loss.
Creighton backs up, pulls it in at the 27. Crosses the 30. And the 37 loses the football. Fresno State's got it. At the 38-yard line, the Bulldogs have recovered. Teams, there's just an example how much.
It certainly is. SC had decided that they were going to go with a 10-man up block. They had nobody back there to block for him, and there the ball is just knocked out. Fresno State recovers. They've got great field position about the 38-yard line.
You can credit Chris Williams for getting that helmet or hand in to knock that ball loose and recovered it.
There it is again. Watch the shoulder actually take the football out. Good reaction by Fresno State to get
the setbacks. Mooney and McFadden. Johnson, pressure. He is going to be sacked at the 48. Rips the nose guard again.
Well, it's been high-powered defenses tonight. This is amazing.
Rob Johnson, he's going for it all, looking for Hanna. And it is intercepted by Fresno State. Sam Watson. Finally brought down at the 28. What an interception and a tremendous return.
Watson is the strong safety on that play, and Phil, and what he's doing is he's just playing center field. Just reading that quarterback's eyes, looking downfield, playing the quarterback. Look how quickly he reacted over there. Great playing the football. Looks it all the way in now. Get upfield. Don't fumble it. Get behind some blockers. Get positive yardage. That's a nice job running with the football once he gets it.
The red wave of... Now, there's a man right there, Trent Dilfer, that Jim Sweeney called the smartest and quickest quarterback that's ever played for him. And you have to stop a minute because his son, Kevin, was a pretty good quarterback at Fresno State.
I bet your mom didn't like that.
Well, that caused some big problems at home. Dilfer. Oh, what a pass. Right over the middle it goes. To the 36-yard line, the tight end, Marty Thompson. His second catch of the night, good for 21 yards.
Johnson starts to run. He just loses all vision downfield.
Estrus Creighton. Nick Surface had the back of his jersey and refused to let Creighton get away.
Surface with those big, strong hands. See him, 91. Run along the line now. Grabbing the hand. Just hold on. Wait for some help. Some of the greatest tackles that you'll ever make are with the ones where you grab a sock, grab a jersey.
Look at the cheerleading going on. Right tackle, and look at that effort. Lorenzo Neal. He reminds me so much, Dave, of that prototypical, that throwback to those Big Ten driving fullbacks.
Yes, we talked earlier, yards after contact. Watch the leg strength that he runs with. Doesn't get his legs taken out from under, just keeps on pulling. And on that play, he's now run 19 times for 76 yards.
Lorenzo Neal is the lone setback. Trip receivers to the left side. Dilfer looking for it. It is caught at the 2-yard line. Titus Winans.
Winans just concentrates on this football because it's not a well-thrown ball. You can see that Dilfer didn't step forward. But look at Winans just concentrate on that football. Look it in. And watch Dilfer. This may be his best pass of the day. Falling backwards, and he throws that football with delivery.
The signals. First and goal, Bulldogs at the 3. Touchdown, Fresno State, and 30 Dangle. Steps up all the time in the world, throws once Hanna. It's intercepted. Intercepted at the 44 by Fresno State's James Burton. The wheels are falling off of this Trojan horse.
The bulletin board. Ooh.
Rivers to the 25.
Football. That's what they're playing right now. There's Hardwick, 70. 69 is Hartman. You see the center, 75, Scott. They're just blowing them off the line. They're controlling the line of scrimmage. Look, there's Hardwick. He's 5-10 yards downfield getting a second block.
They concluded their season against two arch rivals and lost them both in such difficult fashion.
Well, they could have won both football games. And conversely, on the other side of the field, Fresno State won their last five games.
Yeah, at one point, they were 3-4 on the season. To the five and out of bounds. Jason Oliver took him out.
Phil Dilfer snapped that ball on 1 second on the 25-second clock. This is just get outside him. Use that speed. Nothing fancy. Make the break inside, then make it outside. Race to the corner. Picks up a couple good blocks. The receiver's giving them good blocks out there. Charlie Jones is going to do something good tonight, so you be sure to mention him.
Straight ahead it goes. Tremendous homecoming for Ron Rivers from San Bernardino, California.
And look at these offensive linemen. Look at their jerseys. All of them got mud on them. This has been a tough football game from the outset. They have not been intimidated. SC is a powerful team, a powerful tradition. But Fresno State has just not been awed by them.
California. Johnson looking downfield. Down, hold everything. Brian Porter's got it. The senior from Cerritos College says, I've got it.
Maybe a face mask on the tail end of the play. Interesting to see him run to the end zone and just hold up his hands and wave to the crowd.
Face mask.
The interception will stand.
Intercepted. First down.
He'll dunk. He'll be awfully cold by the time he gets to the locker room.
Dilfer again down on a knee. That'll do it. Fresno State, they're going to go wild. The red wave is beside itself.
Look at all the players run into the end zone.
Jim Sweeney. He and Larry Smith, great friends. They meet in the center of the field. An emotional win for Jim Sweeney. A huge step for Fresno State. A convincing victory. Tied 7-all at halftime.
Sweeney, what's this win mean to your program?
Fresno State comes out and shuts down the Trojans of Southern California. Final score, Fresno State 24, Southern Cal 7.